Hello everyone, thank you for having me in 6th International Conference on Industrial, Mechanical, Electrical and Chemical Engineering. My name is Aidil Haryanto. I am the third author of this paper. And the other author's name is Umi Hanifa, Irwan Ardian Sakarim and Andi Taufan. We are from Indonesian Institute of Sciences. And then R. Alfia from Universitas Sebelas Maret, Surakarta. I will present our paper with the title Experimental Performance of a Rotary Decision Wheel Without Honeycomb Matrix Structure, a Preliminary Study. So let's get started. This is the Rotary Decision Wheel System. A decision wheel is a common type of suction dehumidifier using a solid decision. This is the drive motor. And this is the wheel case and the desiccant material as a part of desiccant wheel. Rotary desiccant wheel perform the two function. The first function is as a dehumidification to absorb water vapor in the ambient air so that it can produce dry air. And the dry air can use to drying or the other function. The second function of rotary decision wheel is as a regeneration, the opposite of the dehumidification. Regeneration is used to regenerate decision material by reducing water vapor in the decision material. The effect of this system, low initial and operational cost, relatively environmentally friendly, and it has a significant energy saving potential if it use solar energy and waste heat for its regeneration process. This is the purpose of our paper, to determine the performance of designed rotary decision wheel experimentally. Moreover, the rotary decision wheel is tested for drying the post harvest product such as non-wet noodle, so we use drying process to get the performance design rotary decision wheel. Why do we use non-wet noodle? Because the characteristics of this product is cracked when it is dried under high temperature. Rotary desiccant wheel itself is a drying process with an air suction drying system with a temperature that is not too high. So it is suitable for high temperature sensitive food product. This is our design of desiccant wheel. We get 4 segments and we divide 2 sections. Regeneration section and absorption section. This is silica gel. We fill with 1.8 kilograms silica gel in this. This is the silica gel we use. The diameter 3 until 5 millimeter. Blue is not water vapor, and if relative humidity increase, the color of silica gel like this. Okay, why do we don't use honeycomb matrix structure? Because we use simple design and manufacture. If you silica gel in honeycomb matrix, desiccant must be glue to the honeycomb matrix. This we use glue to insert silica gel in this. So we can the desiccant porosity decrease due to being close with the glue. So what is effective is porous full face that are not glue to the structure. So our initial hypothesis, that we don't use honeycomb, and with a good configuration should have better result because more pores to absorb moisture. This is the schematic diagram of experimental apparatus. We divide two sections. This is the regeneration section and this is the absorption section based on the system of rotary discussion wheel. Okay, in the regeneration section we measure point P4, point P5 and P6. P4 is ambient air, P5 is after heater and the P6 after the discussion wheel. And then the absorption section we measure in the point P1, P2 and P3. This is same with P4, is ambient air, this is after blower and this is after the second wheel. We measure in point is temperature, relative humidity and velocity. The velocity only we measure in P4, P6, P3 and P2. And then in the drying chamber, we include sample in this and we measure the mass of sample during process with load cell, and we measure in drying chamber is temperature and relative humidity. So we can see this is the blower. We use a half horsepower and the heater we use 1 kilowatt, and then to rotate this second wheel we use 1 horsepower electric motor and rotating speed a half RPM. Like this, we can experimental as parameter. And for the humidification process, we use the humidification time is 130 minutes or until the silica gel is blue like the previous slide, and heater temperature set like 60 degrees Celsius, ambient temperature like this, relative humidity like this, and air velocity like this. And then for drying process, we use product non-wet noodle. The mass of non-wet noodle 301 grams. Drying chamber dimension like this, and drying time 17 hours 22 minutes or until the water content is below 10%. Okay, this is a dehumidification process. This is the chart of the dehumidification temperature and relative humidity during the process. Relative humidity tend to decrease after the airflow through the desiccant wheel. Temperature and increase and relative humidity decrease. That means that there is a certain amount of water vapor absorbed by the desiccant. It shows that the absorption process carried out by the desiccant is going well. Okay, this is a piezometric chart. We plot the dry bulb's temperature, relative humidity, and absolute humidity in piezometric chart. So we can see in this the ambient air to the process air. Dry bulb temperature is increased, and then absolute humidity is decreased. The interesting result in the regeneration section, because the absolute humidity P6 is lower than inlet air in P5. And theoretically, the water molecule in the second pores will evaporate to the air when the desiccant is being heated. Ideal condition like this. This is ideal condition. But our experiment condition is this. So based on the structural design, there is a possibility of wet air from the adsorption action flowing into the regeneration section. And maybe another possibility is leaking between section header and the wheel since it is not using mechanical seal. Okay, in the drying process, this is the chart of temperature and relative humidity in the dryer chamber during the drying process. We can see temperature and relative humidity is inversely compression like this. The average temperature is 35.97 degrees Celsius, is higher than the ambient temperature of 29.60 degrees Celsius, and then the average relative humidity of 68.31% is lower than ambient relative humidity of 72.07%. And then this is the chart of mass of sample during the time. We can see the mass of the sample decrease during the time during the process, whereas with the same time sample that were placed in an air conditioned room had a moisture content of 13.2% wet basis. And then in our experiment the moisture content of 9.95% wet basis. This is the compression desiccant wheel effectiveness between this work with other research with Misa et al., Sevan, Isal et al., and Misa et al. In other their research, we can see our research inferior to experiment conducted by the other research like this. It may be not all of the desiccant surface area contact with air. This show there are problem related to the wheel design. Maybe we can see the problem in the previous psychometric analysis. The conclusion. Based on the research and analysis carried out, the author concludes the possible problem that occurred because of wheel design concept. The construction and design of wheel in which the desiccant surface should be exposed more so that it can absorb more water particles in the air. So, desiccant wheel effectiveness is lower than other study. Then the next conclusion, you can see this machine need improvement and development of rotary wheel mechanism for further study. I think thank you very much.